Acme Auto supervisors need a visualization that shows them the size of their vehicle fleet by make and status. The supervisors I am building the chart for are responsible for vehicles manufactured in Germany. The column chart is an excellent choice of visualization for my reporting scenario since it can compare a relatively small set of categories. In this video, I'll configure a column chart to display the German manufactured vehicles by make and status. I'll start by creating an interface for my chart. I will name it Acme Automobile _ German Vehicles by Make Status Column Chart. And I will add a simple description to it to let other developers know what this interface is for. In the Components palette, I'll scroll to Charts. As you can see, the Components palette has multiple chart types, including the column chart that I want. I'll grab and drop the column chart onto the live view. Let's update the label of this chart directly in the interface. I'll label this chart German Vehicles by Make and Status. In my example, I will display a limited number of vehicle makes, so the column chart is a good fit. By the way, if at any point you decide to try out a different chart type, you can click the Convert button to see the conversion options. For example, I can easily convert this column chart to a bar or line chart. Similar to grids, the first step for setting up a chart is to select the source of data. Since using record types is recommended, I will use the vehicle record type as my data source. Note that configuring a chart with a different source is slightly different than this example. I'll click record type. Once I select the vehicle record type, my primary grouping, or the field by which data is aggregated, is auto-populated. Notice the measure property is also populated and shows the number of vehicles for each vehicle make. Right now, the chart is showing all vehicle makes in the fleet. I'll click Filter Records and define which records should be returned. I'll set the field to Make and Condition to In. For value, I'll select Expression and I'll use this constant that stores the make values of German manufactured vehicles. Back in the chart, I see the 5 German manufactured makes. Now my primary grouping, which determines how the data is grouped on the axis, is showing 5 vehicle makes manufactured in Germany. With just this primary grouping, I can see how many vehicles each German make Acme has in the fleet. By adding a secondary grouping, I can show users a vehicle make's different statuses by color. I'll click Add Grouping to add my secondary grouping, which will be a related record field, vehicle status.value. When you define record type relationships, you can easily access those related record fields. Now my chart contains all the data that I need. However, I do not quite like how my status categories are displayed. With all these columns, my chart is hard to grasp at a glance. I can fix this by applying stacking. Let's scroll to stacking. After I select normal, my status-related data per make will be stacked within the same column. Now this layout looks significantly cleaner. However, there is one more detail that I can add to this chart to make it look even better. If I scroll down, I can select the Show Data Labels checkbox. Now, my columns also display the vehicle count for each segment. The next chart property is Measure, which determines the numerical values to display on the chart. By default, the measure gets populated with the count of records. In my case, it got populated with the count of vehicle IDs by default, and this is what I want to use for my column chart. If in your chart you want to use a different type of calculation, you'll have access to additional aggregate functions such as sum, average, count, distinct count, maximum, and minimum. You may notice that we also have the Add Measure button, but it's grayed out. Column charts as well as bar and line charts can display data using multiple measures, but only if the chart does not use a secondary grouping. To give you an example, I created this chart of vehicles grouped by make, with data aggregated by maximum and average mileage. Charts with several measures work well in two scenarios. First, they work well in situations when you want to use different calculations for the same field, like in my example. I aggregated the makes by maximum and average mileage. It also works well when you need to use the same type of calculation, but for two different fields. For example, if you want to compare the sum of cost versus the sum of revenue. By the way, you can also apply filters to measures. This is commonly done for charts that compare two things, when one is inherently part of the other. For example, a comparison between the total number of all vehicle statuses per make and the total number of vehicles with the in-maintenance status per make. To build a chart like this, you'll create a chart of vehicles by make, aggregate data using the count of related status label field, you'll do it twice. Finally, you'll apply a filter to one measure to only count in-maintenance statuses. This type of chart works well when you need to quickly visualize overlapping data. Let's return to the original chart. Below Measure, you'll see the Add Sort button. You can sort by an alias used in the grouping or measure, or by a record field that is not referenced in the chart. I'll select Vehicle Make as my sort field, and I'll choose the ascending order for this sort, so that the makes are displayed alphabetically. Notice that you can also add a secondary sort. Below Sort, you will see the Insert Link button. Adding a link to a chart can be used to create interactive charts that allow a user to select a specific segment of data in the chart, and then use this selection to drill down to a grid with additional information on selected data. Finally, before I add this chart to a report, I would like to review the color scheme. For charts, you can select predefined or create custom color schemes. I'll stay with the rainforest, one of my predefined color schemes. When you work with a multi-chart dashboard, a best practice is to remain consistent when you pick colors for the charts that will be living within the same dashboard.